Greetings, Facebook friends. It is time for our third week of our Advent vlog series, and that means not only is it time for a little encouragement and refreshment, it is also time for our third giveaway, which I can't wait to tell you about in a minute. But for starters, let's get into this book and into that Advent season and that Advent frame of mind. And again, I want to look at Mary. Yet once again, Mary was, of course, the mother of Jesus. And we have experienced a lot with Mary already. But today, we're going to read about the time when Jesus was 8 days old and Mary and Joseph took Jesus to the temple in Jerusalem to be circumcised and for them to offer an offering in thanks to God for their firstborn son. Let's take a look at this passage. It says here in Luke 2, on the 8th day when it was time to circumcise him, he was named Jesus, the name the angel had given him before he had been conceived. Listen to this. Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel. That's just another way of saying he was waiting for the Messiah to come. And the Holy Spirit was upon him, and it had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he saw the Lord's Christ. So here we have this very old man, Simeon, and he's waiting for the Messiah to come so he can die in peace. Moved by the Spirit, he went into the temple courts. When the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what was the custom of the law required, meaning having him circumcised and presenting an offering, Simeon took Jesus in his arms and praised God, saying, "Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, you now dismiss your servant in peace, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all people, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people, Israel." Simeon declared as he held Jesus in his arms, "The Messiah is here. I'm holding him in my arms." The child's father and mother marveled at what was said about Jesus. Then Simeon blessed them, meaning Mary and Joseph, and said to Mary, his mother, "This child is destined to cause the falling and rising of many in Israel and to be a sign that will be spoken against, so that the thoughts of many hearts will be revealed and a sword will pierce your own soul too." Think about that. Why did Simeon only give the bad news to Mary? Joseph got the good news. But then when the bad news came, where did he go? Only Mary got the bad news. Well, what's so interesting is we look further in the Gospels, what we notice is that later on in Jesus's ministry, Joseph was nowhere to be found. It only talks about Mary and her other sons or Jesus's brothers. And of course, at the cross, when Jesus is being crucified, Joseph is not there. Only Mary is there. And later, in the upper room, in the beginning of Acts, we hear that some of Jesus's brothers are also there at that time. And we know that Jesus's brother closest to him, Mary's second-born son, James, became a follower of Jesus and wrote the book of James, which is in our Bibles, and he was also the head of the Jerusalem church. Well, Mary somehow at some point lost her husband. We don't know how. Later, she would stand at the foot of the cross and watch her son be crucified. And about 10 to 15 years later, she would stand again and watch her son James be beheaded. This was a woman who had suffered great loss. Her soul had been pierced. Now, I'm not trying to magnify Mary's loss or minimize anyone else's, because you might feel as though your own soul has been pierced as well. And the reality is that during this holiday season, there are many who feel their souls have been pierced. And with all of the revelry of the holiday and the commercials about family and friends, that piercing can feel like a huge gaping hole right within our hearts. And so this week for our giveaway, I want to tell you about my friend Anita. She has a book called Getting Through What You Can't Get Over. Because let's be realistic. There are some things in this life you will never just get over it. Amen. There are some things we're just never going to get over. So somehow we've got to figure out a way to get through it. And when you think about Christmas, it feels like you're not going to get through it. And that New Year's Day around the corner, well, it doesn't feel very happy at this point in your life. Well, my friend Anita has written a beautiful book that tells real life stories. It offers tips. It offers practical inspiration, ways to walk through the time when your soul has been pierced. And I am offering this as my free giveaway this week because I know there are women out there that are wondering how they're gonna get through this. And they have people in their life that are telling them, don't you think it's time you just get over it? And you know what? You can't get over it, but you can get through it. And Anita is going to help you figure out how to do that. So, if you want to be my winner this week, this is what I want to hear from you. I want to hear your favorite verse that you cling to in times where you are feeling like your soul has been pierced. What are some of your favorite verses that bring you hope, bring you comfort, bring you peace when everything swirling around you feels out of control and hopeless? What's a verse you cling to? A second way that you can win is if you have a friend who's going through a tough time right now, you can tag them in this post and hopefully they will be encouraged as well. Because for Mary, Christmas was not exactly a happy holiday. It was a hard holiday. And for many of us out there, that is the case as well. But you know what? The consolation, just like Simeon told us in Luke 2, the consolation has come. The light has come. And so we have hope. We might not get over it, but we have hope and we have strength to get through it. And I hope and pray that you will find a way walking, holding tightly to your Savior. God bless you.